On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me one holiday camo and a wolf that will bite you in the knees. What's going on, guys? I hope you enjoyed my awful singing voice, but I'm talking about DLC in this game. We're playing some Call of Duty Ghosts. I got the Bulldog with no attachments on it, and we are using the brand new holiday camo that you can get for free right now on Xbox and I believe PC. And I'm also using the new wolf dog skin that I think is just, it's so awesome. It's called the wolf. It's $1.99, and I know that all it does is change what your dog looks like or your attack dog looks like in the multiplayer, but I still think that it's so cool. It's badass. It looks like a stray dog that just pretty much follows you around and takes out people and bites them and kills them. I think that's cool. But with all this DLC, we actually got a couple new things with that, and I'll go into further detail and explain that in just a moment. But with the holiday camo, you actually get the camouflage itself, which I'm using in the gameplay. You get a reticle that resembles a snowflake. You also get a patch and a background, which I think is cool. If you go to select the patch and you go to select the background in your customization screen, you'll actually notice that they're in their very own tabs titled DLC, which makes me wonder, how much more DLC patches, backgrounds are we going to be getting? Camouflages, if that. It just makes me wonder, and it gets me really excited, I'll be honest with you. I know that, a lot of people would disagree that $1.99 for a dog skin is a lot of money, but, you know, no one's forcing you to buy it. It's completely optional. That's up to you if you want to get it. And then once again, going back to the season pass thing, I'm doing air quotes when I say that. Season Pass only basically confirms that you're going to be getting the map packs for free. Anything added on or anything that comes out after the fact, it doesn't really affect or go into effect with that Season Pass. So I think a lot of people say, you know, if I have the Season Pass, I should be getting everything for free. Really, that's not the case. And to be honest with you, like I said, the dog skin, the holiday camo, it's all completely optional. You don't have to download it at all. Granted, the holiday camouflage is free, and it's pretty badass. It just resembles like a really gaudy holiday sweater. Going back to the dog subjects, you don't really need to get that. You don't have to get that. Nobody's forcing you to get it, and it's definitely not giving you an advantage when playing the game. And I think that that's one thing that we'll never see. Like, okay, going to the comparing Battlefield about right now. So if you go and play Battlefield, I don't know if it's the same in Battlefield 4, but I remember in Battlefield 3, if you didn't have the time to rank up or you just didn't feel like ranking up, you could actually buy everything and unlock it. Like, you can buy all the assault packages and the recon packages, I believe, and you could just have everything unlocked at level 1. In Call of Duty, that has never been the case. Like, the only thing that you're able to download or have been able to download since Black Ops 2 was things that really wouldn't give you an advantage in the game, like camouflages and just little things like that, patches, backgrounds, stuff like that. Stuff that only basically is cosmetic, you know what I mean? Things that will change how the game looks for you, but it won't actually change the outcome of a gunfight, I guess I'm trying to say. So with this, with the new DLC tabs, like I was saying, I think it'd be pretty sweet to see like a user custom or like a user customized camouflage, background, and patch. And what I mean by this is, like, we've all seen it before when Black Ops 2 had the emblem editor. A lot of people like to be really childish in the emblems that they make. But I would like to see Infinity Ward, you know, open like a contest to give us the dimensions of a patch, give us the dimensions of a background, and say, okay, here's what we're going to do. You go out, you make the best patch, background, reticle, gun camo that you can. Make sure it all kind of goes together so you can make it one pack. And the winner will basically be put into the game. The winner will have their final camouflage, their background, their patch, and reticle put into the game. Now, there's probably a ton of precautionary things and rules and regulations that Infinity Ward has to go by before actually putting something in a game for millions and millions and millions of people to see. But I'm sure that maybe, I don't know, maybe, just maybe, you're able to do something like that. And I think that'd be cool. So
say somebody does really good with the background and the camouflage, they can say that they are forever in a Call of Duty game. I think that'd be so cool, you know? I don't know how you guys feel about that, but that's just my personal opinion on the DLC tabs. How many more camouflages do you think are going to be coming out? Like, 10, 20? I mean, we didn't see too many, like, we didn't really see too many with Black Ops 2, but that was, once again, the first time in Call of Duty history we've ever had anything like that. So, what do you guys think? What do you think the limit is for camouflage? Are there going to be 10, 20, 30? I mean, really, there's endless possibilities. They're optional. You don't have to download them. I would just like to see a bunch of them just to keep the game fresh and new, seeing different things every single time, or every single time you pick up a weapon, or every single game that you play. But guys, let me know down below in the comment section, what is your personal opinion on the Holiday Camouflage and the Wolf DLC? If you enjoyed this video, please drop the like. If not, that's cool. Keep in mind, I'm on the road to 250,000 subscribers. If you'd like to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. And until next time, I am out. Peace.